All right, okay, let's get to the fluff and the stuff of it all with Wanda. That's me. This time we're on the phone. I've been talking about this show coming up this Saturday. I'm excited. I hope you are too. It's the Autumn Love Show. You know about this, the definition of R&B. We already told you, everybody that's on the bill. Drew Hill, Ginuwine, Maya, and Case on the phone right now with me. I have Miss Maya. Hey, Maya.
Hi, Wanda. How are you?
I'm excited to talk to you. I got a chance to check you out in concert. It was with Faith Evans and 702 up at the casinos up here in Connecticut. And you were outstanding.
Oh, thank you so much. It's always a treat, you know, just be on that stage and engaging and still doing some of the songs and records that we love.
All of the songs, all of your songs were all hits, all phenomenal. And it's been, like you said, it's been about 25 years now. So how does that feel to still get that same love from your fans when they're in the audience, they're singing the love, they're up on their feet like I was? What does that feel like for you?
That's like a blessing, because time just flies right on by for all of us.
Yeah.
But then the journey is just what is so special, and sharing it with those that pretty much grew up with you, you grew up with them. It's a nice exchange, and it's always a privilege. I cannot complain. Man, we're growing out here now.
Exactly.
The fact that R&B music also has this new nostalgia resurgence is beautiful to see, because people really, really come out all over the world, and I'm glad that it's being supported.
And social media has helped that along as well. What is it like when you see people dancing to your music on TikTok or any of like the social media platforms? That has to be incredible, because babies are dancing to you, Maya.
It is so wild. You know, I didn't come out in the age of social media. You know, my very first record was on cassette tape,
right,
and CD. And just to see social media and the power of like all generations that it can reach now is amazing. And so it expands your audience, introduces you to new people that might not have necessarily grown up with you during that time at the click of a button. It's so special. I love it.
Absolutely. How old were you when you released your debut album?
I was 18 years old when I released my very first single and first album.
Wow. That's a long time coming out. I can go through the journey of your career and all of your hits, but because you're going on tour with these gentlemen, I want to focus on one particular song, because you did this song back in the day with Mr. Cisco. I'm not going to sing it. We're not going to do that to our listeners, but it's all about me. And I want to know, are you going to make it all about us and perform that for us this Saturday? Maybe, possibly, kind of, sort of.
Always about y'all, first of all. And then I always perform that song on an R&B show. Now, Cisco and I don't always tour together. So if we get a chance to, of course, rehearse and all that with our crazy travel schedules and everything lines up and the sound is working, you know how things go on stage. We always love to perform that and just give that moment to fans that once again grew up with us and have supported us. Now, my fingers are crossed. But you got to come to the show to see.
I know that's right. Well, our fingers are crossed too. We will be at the show. Maya, you and Cisco, but specifically you have a dance background, right?
Mm-hmm.
So we have to talk about how you still cut up on the stage. Like you still give us these moves. Is it attributed to your diet being vegan? Because you still get busy, Maya.
I mean, once a musician dancer, always a musician dancer. You know, I'm just one of them kids that kind of grew up doing whatever, whatever I felt like it. And I love to dance. I love to sing. I love to write songs. So I will always bring it, you know, even in the heels.
Yes. Killing girl.
The vegan life has definitely done me well as far as still being able to dance. But, you know, more on the healthy side of vegan, because vegan doesn't necessarily look healthy.
Right.
So I gotta still watch what I eat and stay off of the junk food and the rice and the bread and the pasta if I want my knees to be kneeing.
Okay. Come on, knees. I love that for you. This is Maya, if you just tuned in. She's going to be here this weekend, Saturday, for the Autumn Love Tour. You have to be there. Toyota Oakdale Theater. You can get the tickets at livenation.com. Maya, you sing, you dance, you act. There's so much that you have under your belt. Musically speaking, what will we see next from Maya? What are you working on?
Well, that's always a secret, what I'm working on. I've been on tour all year. So I'm excited about some of the upcoming projects that I have been working on the music side, but also in other spaces as well. And I know it takes time for you all to receive it, you know, packaged, ready, and ripe. So I'm going to just keep that to myself until it's time to launch.
I know, but that's right.
All exciting in the vegan space and other spaces, wellness space. And I'm just very excited about the next chapter.
So we need to stay abreast of what's happening in Maya's next chapter. What are your socials so we can follow you and stay on top of this?
Yes, you can follow me at MayaPlanet9 on all social media. And I'm looking forward to coming to the East Coast from where I am right now, my stomping grounds, and giving a heck of a show for all my R&B lovers out there. Thank y'all.
Maya, we thank you so much for taking the time to talk to us. My last and final question for you. We already spoke about your collaboration with Cisco. As you continue to journey through music, who have you not worked with that you want to work with?
Well, I just got out of the studio with them a couple days ago, and that's also a secret. But I did something for their project, and they just did something for mine. So it's like a nice independent swap. And so I just checked that off of my bucket list. It's an icon, though. But, you know, it got to remain in the vault and sealed lips until it's time to announce. But, I just checked one person off of that list.
Okay. Well, congratulations. I'm glad that you got the chance to check that off. We have to be, so let's stalk Maya together collectively so we can find out. And make sure you get your tickets. LiveNation.com, the Autumn Love Tour is this Saturday. Miss Maya, thank you so much for your time today. And we look forward to seeing you.
Me too. See you soon.
Thank you so much, Miss Maya. Now make sure you subscribe so you don't miss an episode of Fluff and Stuff with Wanda. That's me, to find out who we'll be on the phone with next.